Throughout much of the western United States, there is a broad area of similar-looking topography between two distinct mountain ranges. Although this middle area does contain sizable mountains, none are distinctively part of very large mountain ranges. That is, until you suddenly reach a wide stretch of mountains in Oregon, which are in between the Cascade Mountain Range to the west and the Rocky Mountains in Idaho to the east. Known as the Blue Mountains, it really does stand out when you zoom out to see the entire western half of the lower 48 U.S. states. But what if I were to tell you that despite containing the oldest rocks found in all of Oregon, that this entire mountain range, yes, all of it, did not exist until 17 million years ago? Before this, it was actually about the same level as the surrounding topography. So, what major event happened to cause such a vast mountain range to form since then in such a brief geologic time span? The answer is a major and prolonged flood of lava which covered vast swaths of Idaho, Oregon, Washington, and Nevada in several thousand feet thick of lava in a brief geologic time span via what is known as the Columbia River flood basalts. This unusual volcanic province began when the mushroom-shaped plume head of the Yellowstone hotspot interacted with the crust beginning 16.7 million years ago in eastern Oregon. This caused absurdly large volumes of molten rock to intrude into the crust. This caused vast fissures as long as 110 miles in length to erupt at an absurdly high rate for multiple years, flooding the surrounding terrain including regional low and high points in layer after layer of low-viscosity basaltic lava. These eruptions will repeat more than 1,000 times between 16.7 and 15.3 million years ago when they reached their peak, causing multiple lava flows to even run out all the way and reach the Pacific Ocean. By the time the peak phase of activity ended, 81,000 square miles or 210,000 square kilometers of land had been covered in a layer of lava which averaged 3,051 feet or 930 meters thick. However, in some areas, especially close to their source, the total thickness of lava which had erupted was far more significant, reaching up to a whopping 13,000 feet thick in the Pasco Basin. While the aforementioned flood basalt province would continue producing far less frequent eruptions all the way up until 5.5 million years ago, by 14 million years ago, the action caused by all of these intrusions had caused the lowermost layer of the crust to change. After massive basaltic magma intrusion after massive magmatic intrusion placed large volumes of dense rock in the lowermost crust, it caused it to become more and more dense. Eventually, it reached such a high density that large portions of it peeled off and sunk into the mantle via a process known as crustal delamination. Now, for context, while this is an oversimplification, the Earth's crust largely exists by floating on top of the mantle almost like a sponge in water. If you were to cut off the densest portion of the sponge if it happened to be at the bottom, it would cause it to overall rise and become more buoyant. This is exactly what happened between 14 and 10 million years ago, causing the Blue Mountains to be uplifted by up to 6,890 feet or 2,100 meters. The aforementioned uplift was not completely even. There were spots that were more heavily affected than others, resulting in a series of several smaller mountain ranges such as the Strawberry Mountains, the Wallowa Range, and the Elkhorn Mountains. So, why aren't the tops of all these mountains just simply uplifted flood basalt rock? Well, with an increased height comes increased erosion, so in the most uplifted regions what did exist completely eroded away over millions of years, eventually even cutting away at underlying bedrock to expose combinations of ancient sedimentary, metamorphic, and igneous rock dated to between 18 and 400 million years ago. Further erosion by wind and water carved deep valleys, creating the rugged appearance between individual peaks. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Richard for supporting this channel.